Wait, where's your finger at? Let me touch your finger.
Amp's not turning on.
Now we're gonna hear how loud it is.
If you're like me, then you probably want more bass in your car. But you want good subs, and putting them in yourself is way cheaper than getting them done. So this video is going to be showing y'all what it's actually like to put in subs for your first time. I'm trying to grow a positive community with this channel, testing out stuff like this. So if you want me to keep doing this stuff, just, you know, like the video, subscribe, it helps me out a lot. But thanks to all you guys, I went ahead and got this 12-inch Pioneer sub from Walmart, as well as the box. It's Jansen amplifier, amp kit, which comes with the power, ground, RCA cables, and the turn-on REM wire. Last thing you're going to need to get is the speaker wire, and that'll complete the actual kit to install the subs. All that together, put the total right here, but way less than if you're going to go and get them done. It could be upwards from $1,000 to $1,200, depending on what you get. Now, some tools that are going to be helpful for actually installing the subs into your car are going to be some plastic pry tools, a screwdriver set which fits your radio, a wire crimper. Don't forget about this multimeter. It'll save you 2 hours trying to figure out why your gosh darn sub isn't working. Trust me, I'm speaking from personal experience. Thanks, future Carl. So with those tools, that's going to complete the whole subwoofer kit and all the tools you're going to need for installing. I'm going to go step by step and show you all the little tips and tricks that you can do along the way to help, you know, make this an easier experience for you than it was for me. With that being said, I'm Carl Wendell. This is Carl's Garage. And let's go ahead and test out these Walmart subs.
Let's get it. All
right, guys, so we're going to do a bass test of what it sounds like before. So I got my speakers. I'm going to play the same song. Also, go subscribe to this guy. Makes really good beats. Put it on.
Nice.
All right, so that's that one. Y'all can see it's at volume 20. I just turned it up, turned it down. Yeah, but.
All right, yo, first step, of course, when you're doing anything electronically is just to connect the negative terminal on your battery.
Yeah. All right, so we took this bolt out, slipped the power wire in between it. Now we're just going to tighten it back together just so you know we have power for the subs and the amplifier. Next step, you're going to need to find the firewall where you're going to put the cables through to get to your radio, like basically into your cab, like into the car. So of course, on a German vehicle, it's really hard to find.
Can't get it through this wrapping here. It's a mystery tunnel.
All right, we're going to try the wire trick. So we hooked that wire
straight and then bend it.
And then I'll hook it on the other side and we'll try to stick that through. Just so we can pull this wire through that tiny hole right there.
Just waiting for the wire. Oh, that looks so weird. Oh, yes, yes. Move it. Yeah, move it forward, forward.
Holla, Barry.
Oh, hallelujah.
No, I'm just kidding. We got to try to fit this fat ass wire through it. Hey, everyone, just spam prayers in the chat that we get this through. Let's try it. Okay, pull it. Oh my god. Can't describe you what I'm feeling right now. Wait, where's your finger at? Let me touch your finger. Oh, let's go! Yes, give me that. Give me that. Getting this fat wire through that tiny firewall hole actually took us the most amount of time. If you couldn't tell from me spazzing when we actually got it, but we had to take off the cover, the battery, and actually the battery holder to get to it. But I'm just glad we got it done. All right, so once you painstakingly fit your power cable through the firewall, if you own a Volkswagen Jetta, now the challenge is gonna be trying to hide the wire going into the trunk. Now we got one power cable going to the trunk, which we need to put a fuse on. Cause if we don't, and then it blows or whatever, it could fuck up the wire, right? And then we blow up, so put a fuse.
Yeah, okay, I'm gonna cut it up here.
Okay, do it.
Yeah?
Yeah, fuck it.
Yeah?
Even our master electricians mess up. I forgot this part.
Shit.
I'm
Is our cameraman doing nothing? Right, good job, electrician. We got one side done. It's pretty sturdy. All right, but we got the fuse put on. Now we're gonna hook up everything and then bring the sub to the trunk.
So you're probably wondering why we have a different sub here and in the intro than we do in the video. Well, in short, we f***ed up the wattages and ended up blowing the sub. If you're new to this, make sure you match up the wattages. The subs was about 300 watts and the amplifier was a 1200 watt peak. So we turned up the gain a lot, ended up blowing the sub. This is a 1400 watt peak sub, so it'll be perfect for the amp. It's more than the amp. Just, you know, research it before, match up the wattages, and you'll save yourself a lot of time and money. Also, get the warranty. Just word of experience, get the warranty. Get it.
We're gonna get your nice little amp here, and we're gonna find somewhere to ground it to. So if you just lift up here to where you see the spare tire, hopefully there is a bolt, an unpainted bolt. That would be optimal, but I don't think so.
Oh man.
I'm just gonna have to drill a hole.
Oh. I'm a pro at holding the flashlight. My dad taught me well.
The flashlight? What the flashlight? Look at this dude showing up in an hour late. This is our cameraman, bro. You're not getting paid for this video. Just kidding, y'all aren't getting paid. Because I'm not.
Hey, go hit that subscribe button, then I can pay them.
So, we got the power cable through. Now we got the ground cable connected. A beautiful job by Fonzie himself. Now we just need to get the RCA cables from the radio to the rear of the car. We'll plug everything into the amp, plug the amp into the subs, and then we should be good. Hopefully. Let's try it out. So now, the next step is gonna be to get it behind your radio. If you have an aftermarket radio, then it's gonna be plug and play. It has ports for the RCA cables to plug straight into. But if you have a stock radio, then you're gonna need to get a converter. Sucks to suck. Taking apart your dash, your radio is gonna be different in every car, so I'm not gonna record this one, but you just pop out stuff and you have a bunch of T20 screws.
Why does that tool look kinda weird?
Looks like... Hey, Alfonso, can you hand me that other orange clip?
Which one's
there? Wait, pause. Grab it.
Which one's there?
Alright.
All right, so we got the RCA cables. We're gonna plug these into the rear. I don't know how they match up. I'm guessing this lighter gray one goes to the white. This one goes to the red, but we'll leave this open, run it. Hopefully it works. But we have the RCA cables plugged into the radio. We also need this power.
It's the turn on REM wire, you doofus.
Plugged into the radio. So there's a screw with like 12 volts, 500 MA on it. So I believe that's the power. So we're gonna hook this up to an attachment that it came with. Alfonso's doing that, he's an electrician guy, but we're gonna hook it up to where we can screw it under that screw and we're good. So for the radio part, you just need the RCA cables plugged in and the power. Basically, like whenever you turn on the radio, it's gonna turn on the amplifier. So one good tip is to not run these on the same side. If they're close to each other, that could cause disturbance and then make the music quality go down a little bit. So it's best just to throw these on each side of the car, keep them separated while you're sending them back to the trunk. And we're gonna do that, and I'll meet y'all back in the trunk. All right, so we got our amplifier. There's two sides. One where you're gonna plug your RCA cables into on the input. And also on the other side, you got your battery. We're gonna plug in the power cable, blue one.
Oh.
And you got your ground where you're gonna put the black wire. Then you got your output, mono, because we only got one. We're gonna plug the speaker wire in.
Right, let's see it.
Noiseless shit.
Yeah.
How the fuck do they do this?
Do it. Just do it. All the way.
I just plugged it.
There you go. Oh, you f***ing up. You fucked. No. All right, other one. I see it. 2 for 2. I guess it's done. We're going to try it out now and hope for the best. Hopefully we don't blow up. Let's try it.
Fonzo.
Got it plugged in. Let's try it. Why? I obviously do. Okay. That's at 20. That, but that was what we were at last time.
Oh, the bass is definitely different, dude.
Slight technical difficulties. Amp's not turning on.
Remember when I told you about the multimeter? Now's the time to use it.
But really, the REM turn-on wire wasn't getting 12 volts, so it wasn't getting enough power, but I came up with this little trick.
All right, new plan. Since the plug in the back is only pulling about 5.5 volts, I'm gonna use this. I read in the manual that the red is for power for the ignition. Black, you can see, is ground. I just plugged it up to the voltmeter and got 12 point something volts. So I'm gonna cut into this red wire, hook up the blue wire, the REM wire. That didn't work on here for some reason. All right, I've twisted up those wires. Very good. I tested the ignition. It still runs, it still turns on. Take my voltmeter, go test that REM cable in the back. But see, look, right whenever I start to play music, it does this. Someone could let me know why.
I know why it's not working. The ground connection needs to be secured to a spot where it's connected to raw metal.
Oh, thank you, Future Carl. Well, will this spot here be good? I sanded it in and I bolted it in. So, will this be good?
Yes, Past Carl, that'd be a great spot to connect it to. Now go ahead and try it out and see if it'll work now.
Okay, so we got the actual subs working. We're gonna do the test now with like the decibel thing. I'm at 20, you can see that's where we had it before. Doors open.
Did we have all the doors open or just two
doors? I think just two. Hey, let me look at the video. All right, so all the doors are open. Go subscribe to this guy and just double check. Volume's at 20. Okay, all right.
Start it.
Okay.
I can hear it.
This shit's loud.
I'm happy with that. I mean, it took us a little bit, like, what, like, I would say 5 hours total, like, from the first day and second day.
We just struggled with the power.
Okay, so that test was with the 10-inch subwoofers that accidentally blew, but now we got the 12-inch Pioneer ones in the back, and then we're gonna test it out now. I got the decibel reader again, put at the same volume, and yeah, we'll see how loud it is. I'm gonna put it at 20 again. Okay, well, damn! I fuck with these Walmart subs.
These are badass.
But yeah, if this helped you out at all, like and subscribe.
And subscribe.
And share. Help me out a lot.
Yes.
So I could pay him. I'm not gonna pay the cameraman, because... but
he broke the car right there.
Yeah, bro, you broke the car right there. Like, that's fucked up. You can't really see it, but yeah, pull it down. See? Nice O'Shea
he
handle.
He even did that.
And this too. Like, he just fucking up my car. All right, we'll see you on the next one.
My shit hard right now, nonetheless.
The bass. Oh, thank God.